everything inside me, and you help to light up everyone around you.
All right, you guys, let's get right into it. We're going to talk about Godwin Island, Tay Godwin himself, the sixth round pick, 223rd pick overall in the 2021 NFL draft class, taken by the Arizona Cardinals. And we got to get right into it. All right, guys, I really, really like this kid. I've been watching a lot of film on him. I've been watching a lot of his background and his history and things of that nature, playing a little football for UCF in 2019, shutting down just about everything that was thrown his way. And then ultimately, just being able to be picked up and drafted by the Arizona Cardinals. The kid felt like he was slept on, felt like a lot of teams passed him up. And rightfully so, when you're taken in the sixth round and you feel like you should be a third round pick, fourth round pick, or even higher, you know, hey, this is the pros and cons of being in the draft. You just never know what's going to happen on that day. But I definitely think that the Cardinals have found them a guy that can be that next dude. Definitely have been already given the nickname Godwin Island. I love everything about this kid. I love his intensity. I love what his intangibles. I love everything that he's going to bring to the game of football. His IQ is really, really high. And the biggest thing now for him is just to learn, come in and learn under the veterans, guys like Malcolm Butler and Alford, who they brought back on the team, which I really don't trust Robert Alford, especially the last couple past seasons with his injuries per se. But the Cardinals also drafted another cornerback too as well in Marco Wilson out of Florida. So you got two young guys that will be competing to probably be rotational guys or even just competing at the cornerback spot, period. They may not start right away and things of that nature, but at the same time, these guys are going to be competing. And I definitely think that Tay Godwin could be a steal in this draft. The intangibles of him just being a playmaker, being a guy that takes and shuts down one side of the field, is something that you really, really have to love and adore if you're an Arizona Cardinals fan, because you had that many seasons with Patrick Peterson, who was a shutdown corner, who shut down everything that pretty much came his way. Picked the ball off, batted the ball down. Whatever he had to do to make a play, he made that play. And now you no longer have Patrick Peterson a part of this team anymore, and you have to go with the youth movement. And I think that's the reason why Patrick Peterson is no longer on his team, is because the Arizona Cardinals decided to go with the youth movement over bringing Patrick Peterson back. But it is what it is. I think Tay Godwin has a shot at being a starter in this league once he gets his opportunity and be given the keys to drive the car. I think that this kid is going to take that spot over. And I think that him and Marco Wilson could be eventually the future at cornerback for the Arizona Cardinals. Now, Tay Godwin, who is a guy that has gone through a lot in his life, but even though he's gone through a lot, he still approaches the game with respect for the game. The dude is a student of the game, and he only wants to get better. And you have to feel that way about yourself, that you were the steal of the draft. And just like he said, you know, other players that wore the number 32, you know, because he didn't have that many options as far as what jersey that he was going to pick. Buda Baker gave up 32 and decided to rock out with number 3. So now Tay Godwin gets the opportunity to rock the jersey. We know that the Honey Badger also wore 32 when he was with the Cardinals. So we'll find out if Tay Godwin has really what it takes to take this team and propel this team to the next level with his play. You know, whether it's going to be on special teams starting out or just being a rotational guy, I definitely think that Tay Godwin is going to be a monster in the NFL once he gets his opportunity, because this kid is coming in with the attitude is that, hey, I want to be the same thing that Tom Brady was in the sixth round. I want to be that at the cornerback position. And when you got a guy talking like that, man, and he knows what he has in himself and he's confident in himself, then, man, sky's is the limit for this young guy. So I definitely think the Arizona Cardinals have possibly gotten a steal with getting him later, even though I thought that the Arizona Cardinals was going to take a corner with the first pick in the draft. But they decided to take the linebacker, so they went BPA, which stands for best player available, That's what the Cardinals decided to do instead of grabbing a cornerback. So I'm not mad at them for doing that. They had to do what they had to do. They grabbed one of the best linebackers in the draft in Zaven Collins, who I think is going to be a monster on this Cardinals defense. But Tay Godwin, skies is the limit for this kid. Now can't wait to see what he brings to the Arizona Cardinals in the future. So, all right, guys, make sure you subscribe, and I'll be back to you soon. Peace.
You helped me love everything inside me, and you helped to light up everyone around you. I see you grow when you open up your eyes to smile at me. I see you grow when you open up your arms. Everyone around you can feel your light.